Hey guys, it me once again. I was just looking at the wrong fucking audio channel, not channel, the wrong thing on the mixer. God, that is way too fucking loud for me. It shouldn't affect you guys any, so don't worry about that. Da-da-da-da. So, the Great Fairy Mask, and I'm kind of jumping into this, but this should be going up like a little later in the day after the first part did. I mean, the first part of this segment, I guess you'd call it. So, the Great Fairy Mask basically attracts those to me, and it also shimmers if there is a stray fairy. So, if I put that on and there's those little pink sparkles, I know there's a stray fairy in the room. And if I find one that's out in the open and I free it or whatever, then that's how I get it to come to me. Otherwise, it'll just either kind of sit in place or, like, slowly drift away from me. But I am gonna scream. And, you know, sometimes I just do that. Okay, am I, like, this is how I'm supposed to do this, but those, like, try to eat you if you're on them for too long. Welp. I'm fucked up. Wait, I can get to that from here. There's one here. And I think there's only two left in this room. Or one. I think there's only one, and it's that one we saw. No, there's two. I remember now. I was listening. I don't think this is what I was supposed to do. No, maybe it is. Compass? Oh, no, smoking. Right, that's not a big chest. You may be wondering, how I remember where all these are, and Woodfall isn't too difficult to remember. It's relatively small. I actually think, even though they do get progressively bigger as you progress, I feel like the next dungeon and the final one are like the two biggest ones. I don't know how you're supposed to figure this shit out. I guess it makes sense, because the fucking the fireflies or whatever kind of teach you. Or not the firefly, the fucking little dude, the dudes with the little stingers. You know what I mean. Things I killed on the way in here, and on the way to get the souls. Boring. So now I can kind of see where I'm going. Just realized I want that equipped for reasons we will soon understand. I promise. It's gonna make sense.
It'll be wonderful.
Anyway... So, there's... Yes, thanks, Tattle. There's a couple of these in here. And, one I'm gonna show... is, oh yeah, they can be enemies too. There's one down there I can't get because the water is... lethal. Now I'm gonna push this out of the way. I accidentally went the right way. Okay. Oh, I know what to do here. And also simultaneously make this harder. I promise I use my brain. Okay, the fucking swinging wasn't intentional, or the swing was intentional, but going flying like that wasn't. What are these called? Dragonfly? They're literally called Dragonfly. I didn't remember that. I was just calling them that because they made me think of them. And the compass. And there's Link's big chest opening. I really like the Deku Scrub one. Where he just fucking hops inside it. I guess magic? Magic, please? Magic? I'm stupid. I feel like there's a reason I didn't do that. That's gonna be crucial for me doing what I have to do and live up to my family name and face full life consequences. Okay. I think there's one in this beehive here, but it could be the one underneath me. That was stupidity on my part. That was not the one. Also, that little sound will play if there's a stray one that's, yeah, able to come to you. I could probably do some weird shit and, like, snipe that damn thing with, Deku Link's bubble, but... Yeah, that's cool. I only have the one, so I would like to not fucking... Okay. was a kind of fun room. I sense a lot of evil in here. And there's a reason I'm killing these. Well, one, that door's locked, but these are probably one of the most annoying enemies in the game. And I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Because of this would literally make this so much easier. Is that it? Nope. Was that it? It was. Nice. Okay. And that's how you open the door. You're probably wondering why I keep doing that. It's literally just to put out the fucking... checking. I couldn't quite remember. I don't, for some reason, this room always feels like there's one in here. Also, in the 3DS version, those platforms don't move till you land on them. I am going to try and cheese this a little bit. I mean, it would probably be faster to just let go now and fly to that, but... that was unintentional. Okay. That one. Oh, right, I forgot Deku. There's kind of a wait though. It's not complicated. It literally is just Deku Link can activate normal sized switches because he's too small. He's not heavy enough. Also, that gave me a way back up here. And this is the room that I thought I was in earlier when I swapped to Link, but it, irregular Link, but it was the Dragon Fingers. Right, this isn't fucking... this isn't fucking PSO2 where I can sidestep and I just get invincibility frames through the flyer. The frequent flyer. And I just like this one better. That's kind of a stupid thing to do because it's wasting a little bit of time because I think I know what this is. Actually, it has to be or I'm fucked. Because if it wasn't the bow, I literally could not progress the fucking dungeon. The randomizer kind of fucked with me a wee bit. Like, thankfully, I know enough about this game to fucking, like... that looks right. I know enough about this game to play the randomizer, but it's not like Super Metroid randomized, where like I actually know how to speedrun this game. I just don't, because that's not literally what I do with. Like, that is literally like my experience with Super Metroid. I could learn to speedrun, like I could learn the route to speedrun that game, and put in the time to like get the actual skill to do it. I just don't. And probably wondering how we unlock this door. The answer may surprise you, because it's literally that. Oh, there was one more in here. Shit. I kind of forgot to activate the chest. Now I can go in the water, which means I actually need to go in this next room over here, too. Because that fairy that's underwater, now that I can either pop it with the bow or there should only be five left, I believe, and we're still not exactly done. But, I mean, oh, no, I do have to go underwater. You can't snipe that one because of this stuff. Hey, you know what? Fuck you too. So there's four left. I mean, you can fucking count. There's 15 per fucking dungeon. I know where. Actually, no, I know where all four of them are. They're all in the same room. I hope I'm right about that. It has been a wee little bit, but I think I'm right. As long as I think I'm right, that's all that matters. I think this should be the room that all the fairies are in. So, let's just do that real quick. Because as you'll see, there's a door over there that requires a key. But, we do not have a key that will fit that door. We also have no keys. But we did open a door earlier, so, you know. If you haven't figured out where the key is yet, you're a little bit behind mentally. And I don't appreciate that. I don't like stupid people. And they'll save that one for later. Though it might actually be quicker to get it now and Song of Soaring to the entrance, if that works in this one like I'm thinking it does, and then go turn it in. Well, I would, but you're not letting me equip my Ocarina, so now we never have to put the fairy mask on in this dungeon again. Yes. Awesome. That's exactly how I wanted that to work. I wish I could, like, selectively do shit. With the randomizer and like have the Song of Soren shortened after the first time it's used. But why is the water out here poisoned? I depoisoned the water inside the dungeon. Okay. I just realized what my dumbass is. That is not gonna make it. What is wrong with you, Shade? Are you? This is the fairy fountain. If you go here without these, it's the same thing as the one in Clock Town. Or like when you pick the one in the piece up in Clock Town where she's like, "Help me, the Skull Kid has split me into pieces." Oh. I got the second charge to the spin. I thought this was extended magic. Huh. Well, that will be helpful. Also, it doesn't use magic when you do it like that. If you see me, like, spastically fucking doing this, it does the full charge without you having to, use magic. Some prefer the gyroscope controls from the 3DS version. Personally, I like this a bit better. Not on the N64 version, though. Some of you may notice my dumbass has a hard time moving in a straight line. That's not the controller. That's just my brain. I think I could get to the dungeon entrance from here, or from that one, but I'm not gonna risk it and have to fucking re-flower. Okay. Time to go get that fucking boss key. I think I could just skip this one, but... where's the fun in that? This is gonna be where I got smacked out of the fucking air by a Skatula. Allow me to introduce you, ladies and gentlemen. Ow. I was like, what the fuck? I guess because I left, I have to do this again, but I'm so glad those things do not have a proper hitbox. That should be good enough. Barely. Actually, I think jump attacking would have been two when he would have gone to this phase, and... Not that hard. I mean, I did get hit once, but it was my own stupidity. God, I've got like this fucking window small. I've got it windowed. As normal people call it, and there's a fucking, I got Chrome open in the back from where I'm uploading this other part, and fucking got a Mark video in the back, and for some reason when Link was opening the chest it started fucking looking like he was moving. You may be wondering why I'm not using bunny herd here, and to me it would kind of be slower to... You know... Bunny Link, or bunny hold, and then have to basically immediately transform again. Okay. And it's show time. Also, if you get to one of these without the boss key, I think Tattle just yells at you. So you actually have to fight this dude in a proper fucking way in 3D. But as far as I'm aware, I'm gonna try and beat him as Deku Link, but I don't think he fucking... So I'm gonna try something. Okay then. Well. Link, please. Is he saying Tadomu? Okay, that's it. I've had enough of this shit. He's almost dead. I didn't do that one on purpose. That's the second easiest boss in the game. And you're probably wondering how the fuck the first boss is the second easiest. And you'll see in the next dungeon. you figured it out. Actually, I think they just fucking flat out explain it here. So I think as soon as I get this next mask, I can go and get a Pona. I'm not 100%. I've never actually tried sequence breaking this before. Oh, okay. Sorry, Majida. Majikas. Actually, that might be a little bit more of a formal way to say that. And we need something to carry her around in. And the only thing I got to carry her with is my hands and this. There's a side quest thing we can do here after this that I'm not gonna fucking bother with. What am I doing? I told you once, now I've told you once, and I've told you once. For some reason, you can't take her out here, like right at the entrance. I didn't get him captured in this timeline, did I? I think I went back to the first. Yeah, I did. I got the Sonata and then finished up part of the Anjouan Cafe quest and then reset. And okay. He's supposed to be in the pyre, or in that fire, on a like fucking stake basically tied to it. Yeah, I appreciate it. Well, no, that's right, I did say I was gonna do all the masks, didn't I? Spoiler alert, it's a mask that isn't particularly useful right now. Because... There we go. Actually, I'm curious. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna do something stupid. Just to speed this up. What am I doing? Nothing heard about it, man. I know we've already established this, but masks go back in time with you. So if you do that again, I think you just get a heart piece. There's a couple of these you have to fucking do twice. As to why I am doing this, don't question me. Just forgot the notes for a second there. Not gonna lie. Now we're gonna go back to Clock Tower.
Towel. I keep saying tower when I mean to say towel, and also when I mean to say town. Now there is one sequence break I could do here. If I were persistent. And also, they just reminded me of... Right. It's north. One and two are opposite each other, three and four are opposite each other. I hear that. Doesn't that sound familiar? It says something about healing of sorrows in the 3DS version, if I remember right, so it's a little bit more apparent that you do this. Okay. Oh, right, you can't get that till fucking here, I think, actually. I don't remember how you get that mask. What am I doing? Oh, right. Okay. I remembered what I was doing. What I actually say going out of the proper exit. God, that does not that does not fucking translate to English well. Teacher would be a little bit more applicable to what they're fucking saying. Huh. That's after he does delivery, so I'm probably late. Like like my mom was when she was pregnant with me. Getting out of here before the robbery. Oh, you can't. Okay. You may be thinking to yourself, but Shade, how are we going to get up here? How are we going to go here? There's a giant thing of ice. Well, Tattle and Phelps land for us. If you had something that could pierce, it looks like it would take two shots. No shit. Look at that. So, I didn't think about it, but this is part of the reason I grabbed the mask that I did. Also, if you dally around... Wait, what am I doing? I don't need Deku here. If you dally around long enough in, like, town or whatever, Tattle will eventually get annoyed with you and be like, we're going to the mountain next. I think she'll also say it on a reset after you finished Woodfall. Because they expect it to take longer for you to get to this point. And I mean, it, your first time, it probably will. Because you're not going to know every single place to go in the dungeon. The way to Snowhead. So, I mean, that's probably the way we should go, right? Just like right through here. And we can't jump that. We had a grappling hook or something, we might be able to, but we can't make that jump. Okay. So what do we do now? Well, this is a big area. There's a tall mountain. And what looks like a... Oops, I'm not looking at the right spot. There's a tall mountain, and it looks like a cliff head out there. But we got no way to climb it. Anyway. Goodbye, White Wolf. So I'm actually kind of stuck using the blast mask instead of bombs. I kind of fucked up, but let's investigate. This, I actually don't know what hints at this being here. No doubt. So now I don't need the blast mask. And this is one of my favorite items. Not because of what it does, just because of how it looks. Also, yeah, you need magic to. See the truth, in quotes. fucking try this. Like, it's... If you know where it is, you can open it. Or if you get lucky. So now we can see why the, the feathers were floating in midair. There's supposed to be a shadow that you can see. I'm just gonna mute for a little bit here. Sorry about that. There's some noises outside my room. The coin won't be getting picked up, and I thought maybe I was about to get interrupted. And now that we're in this part of the game, after I finish Snowhead and restore the Great Fairy, is what I'm going to call this part. And the way this is going, this will just be like one fucking recording session after this, and then I'll start like... Because this is like a day after the one that's going up. Okay, this is weird for... For people watching it, this, it's the 30th. For me, it's the 28th right now. I recorded the previous to this one on the 27th. After taking a break, because I was getting a little bit burnt out doing all the side quest stuff. After this, it's going to be pretty straightforward of me just knocking shit out, except for maybe what comes after this next dungeon. Where he's like, heal me. If only you had some sort of melody that could heal me. And this is something I like. So, you're turning into these creatures. You're technically turning into that person.
And the hint is the Deku Butler.
Also, they're heavy as shit, so water weighs them down even something I am spoiled on from the 3DS remake. The 3DS one, you press it and it stays. You stay curled up until you press the button again. Yeah. Shit. So we got some prune water now. Some ring water. Well, we're gonna be coming back up here in a second. I could have
close. Damn it. And that's actually your new step out here. And he says something about it being warm beneath your grave. And that's kind of your hint about this shit I just did. Uh-huh. Link, please. So. This is like your fastest fucking movement, as far as I'm aware. There is nothing we can do for him. That would be annoying if I forgot that. So, there's a side quest here with the smithy, with the hot water. I'm not gonna bother with it. Because... second. There we go. I was concerned for a second there. Let's bring it this way. Man, the reason for that is, you know, they said something about the elder. Elder went off the fucking snow. You know, well, we're doing it. What? You better tell him we're on the case. Giant cock. Because our boy here is so fucking heavy. He can climb, but he cannot grab ledges when he's a Goron. Also, this is one of my favorite transformations in any Zelda game other than the rings in Oracle of Seasons and Ages. let's go the right fucking way this time. Okay. Didn't remember it doing that. He's an ancient Gorgon, so he must be a village elder. I must have, like, put more pressure down on that than I thought I did. I legitimately did not touch the A button there. They just randomly go quiet for seemingly no reason. It's because personal stuff. I'm a special boy. Trip to get some spring water to try and see if I can do something a little bit preemptively, because if I can do that, I can do a side quest and get home and start doing some weird sequence breaking shit. But there is something that if I can get a couple of things out. In between Snowhead and Woodfall. So the next plot that we're supposed to do is... go back to the corner, then let's play the lullaby for the child. Different caliber of Specifically, I am doing the sequence break. That's not the right way, you idiot. We should be good in that regard, but damn it. These come out quick, these punches come out fucking quicker in the 3DS version. Even a birthday. No, I just don't have the herpes. You're probably wondering why. Like, doing that, but I'd still avoid using magic. Yes, that's literally the only thing he couldn't remember. This is not what I was saying with my magic, I'm just... this fucking chandelier. I've gotten lucky with this every time I've done another randomizer, unless the randomizer is set to make every pond or the first pond you break have it in it. By the way, this is not a key item, like with the pendant or, stupid. I apologize for how long this is taking. There we go. I'm probably wondering what this is for. Well, remember that Goron that said he was hungry? I'm gonna get this, and I'm gonna start the dungeon, but I'm not gonna finish it in this cycle, more than likely. This is one I don't particularly care for, so I remember the least of it, but it'll be fine, I'm sure. I did it to avoid the wolves, in case you're curious. So this team was... oops. Turn was falling into a mask. So this mask is completely useless right now. You cannot carry that as a regular one. So I just wrote, can we want to see him hip-hop around, or... chain. What the fuck? Why didn't you come here earlier after you got up? She says there's something in the blizzard, but we can't see it. There's a Goron just fucking yelling out ice. And, well, he's causing a blizzard. He's dead. So I think they... Yeah, you just have to inspect them in 3DS version. And you activate these. That hole it showed is the fairy fountain. The one up here is the dungeon. Have been pissed. Thanks, I hadn't figured out I can move these yet. There we go. I'm so used to being able to sequence break this that... I am literally... What? Okay. I don't know what the fuck's going on there, but that's some bullshit. I am gonna fucking yeet non-existence into existence. What? Why do you do these things to me? Why do you do? some reason that's no fucking problem. First things first. Well, we already learned from the one dungeon that we can just break shit like that. Let's do this. If I had certain something, I could bullshit my way up there, but I do not have that, so I cannot. Anyway. It's a key. It's a fucking... No. It's a fucking key. No, it doesn't. It is a key. I mean, you know it's here, I just got it. But did you know it's also used to open locked doors? There is a point to this, do not worry. Please, do not worry. There is a point to this. I promise. Goddamn a key. Okay. So I can't do anything about that, because I'd have to get, like, fucking spring water in here, and... Yeah, no, that's not happening. But there is something I can do. I think. Stop cock blocking me, please. And there is a fairy in here. Und fairy. Right here. In fact. Hey, this is the only one in here. Yay! The game is nice sometimes when it wants to be. Another key. This room is ass.
Yes.
So I don't know if it's because of my, like, display driver or graphics plugin or what. There's a fairy up there. She's telling me to do this. There's no timer on that. Thank Christ. Fucking remembered why there's a problem with that one. It's because the fucking guide I used initially fucking lies to you. Kind of. It tells you to fucking basically get right under it and aim straight up, but you aim like what I just did. this is a pretty fun one. I'm not the brightest snowflake in the garden. There is a reason for this. I genuinely can't believe I fucked that up like that. I'm a doofus. So now I need to go back into this fucking ice boy room and go back up those steps. Oh wait, no, I can't. I have to do this the way I did it before. Because I'm special. I'm your little baby boy. I got 64 messages on Telegram. This is a game for the N64. That's cool. I fucked up because you're supposed to do this. Damn it. At least this one's nice. Try something. I don't think it'll work. Oh. Okay. Fucker. Step into the own zone, bitch. Okay. Now, if I fuck this next one up, I can climb up a lot quicker. Nope, okay. Now, I'm gonna go in here. Why? That's fairy. That is the only thing I don't fucking like. Okay. So this next. this is like a, you know, it's funny I say that immediately. I'm like, oh, but wait a minute. This is one of my favorite Zeldas. Like, is my favorite Zelda game, which to me is hilarious because it fucking terrified me as a kid. Especially those fucking mask transformations. Was so fucking terrifying as a kid. Oh yeah, I can melt that shit now, but there's no point. It's just rubies. Sorry. People being fucking annoying in my house. That never fucking stops, by the way. It's a little bit why it takes as much for me to, like, get the energy to fucking record. Here's the map. Or a key. It's one of those two. I think it's a key. Going by the size. You may be, like, partially wondering what I'm doing. And just lower the damn thing, but it's because I can get to the side of the room I need to be. It's a key. So that was required. So I can go back up into this room we were in earlier.
Oh
my god. I have cleared this fucking dungeon one thing now.
I'm not gonna get to those until I'm...
just to get myself used to it. No, I don't need this yet. Thank you. just tried to do something with a candy. Oof. Oh. What's funny is I think that one stays marked. And now I have to reclimb this fucking tower. It's a 5 to save state, but I do this just to save you guys me having to reclimb the goddamn tower. Oh, thank Christ. Wait, hold on. I'm sorry. I'm an idiot. wish there was a way to bullshit that and knock off the loose. It doesn't. Okay. So, actually, that makes it a little bit easier. Risky. No, it's this one that I'm right on top of. Now, I can just do this. My favorite thing is if you fuck up, you have to do like a really weird angled fucking thing. So, yeah. Uh-oh. Nice job breaking it. Actually, this didn't break anything. Like, we would not have been able to kill it. Literally at all. I think that hits harder. That was not by choice. The Goron's just a wee bit harder to control. If I could hit a ramp, and then it, that'd be dope. Yeah, I'm actually convinced that is quicker than fucking... fucking nose itching. That's not why I got hit. I got hit because I'm bad. You asshole. Link, please. Even though it's the terrain and me being, like, epic stupid. I'm gonna eat shit. it's a lot quicker. I don't know why the fuck I never tried doing that more consistently. Holy shit. Damn, why do these keep coming out about the same time? Fucking the next one they come are gonna take even longer. No more voice acting. Even for the Happy Mask salesman. So, when I get the upgrade from the fairy, I'm gonna Song of Time back to the first day off screen, and basically do that fight again. And start from there. So the next part's gonna be, like, a little bit further ahead. But I'm gonna show the Great Fairy and what she gives. Come on. We don't have to take this long. It's spring now. Finally came. It's finally here. It's finally Friday. Oh, fuck. I forgot I was recording for a second there. Right, I forgot it's just left and right. You can't do up and down on that. This is going to make no, wait, yeah, that would be okay. I just fucking passed. And yes, I'm deliberately going to these as the fucking species of that area. Okay, now I'm trying to think before I do this because it could fuck me if there's anything else I need to do, but I don't. Oh! And deposit rupees, I'm gonna do that off screen. And then Song of Time back to the first day and get back to this point, but on the first day, and we're gonna go from there. I'll see you in the next part.